Let us pray together. Eternal Almighty God, who is our Father, thank you.
Thank you.
Over and over again, Father.
Thank you, Father.
For your grace and your mercy, for your love and kindness, we thank you.
Yes, Father.
Thank you for yet another day.
Thank you.
Thank you for this, your man servant, being ordained today. We thank you, God, for Harvey and his family.
Yes, Father.
Pray now your blessings upon them, your guidance and your peace. Speak to our hearts and minds today, O God, as we again search your word.
Yes, sir.
God, it is all for your glory.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
We love you. We bless your name now. In Jesus' strong name we pray. And all God's people said, amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Well, this is the day that the Lord has made.
Yes,
sir. I think we'll rejoice. Amen. And again, it's for your glory, God. To the angel of this house, Pastor Harvey, we thank you for the invitation to come and to share as we tag team on this candidate. Amen. Your beloved son, in whom you're well pleased. We thank God. We thank God for this invitation to come and to share. Your lovely wife as well. I'm happy to have my lovely wife here. Sister Anne, wave hand. She's there. Amen. I did good. Yes. Thank you. I'm married up. Good to see some of the members of Mount Carmel who traveled as well to come and to share with the Harveys. And we thank God for them sharing also this I guess I'm going to call them KBB, Keisha, Brandon, and Bay. KBB.
Right.
They come and they've shared. And glad they're here today. Amen.
Hey.
Amen. Yeah. Harvey, God bless you. We thank God for the Harvey and his lovely wife, son, and daughter. We thank God for their communing with us at Mount Carmel several years now, and about to make another transition. But want them to know that we love them, and we were blessed to meet them, to share with them here. Have a unique ministry whereby we love to teach the word of God, good preacher as well, but also understands practical ministry. Did some hair cutting in the community. Didn't have to cut mine, but there were others who had hair and shared in that way as well. And just tried to make it real plain and simple that there's a lot of ways to do ministry. And
all right.
We should never box God in. Just
all right.
Use the gift that God has given unto you, and then God will be glorified in our sharing. So again, it's just good to be in this place called Geneva, Alabama.
Yes,
amen. To come and to share in this great occasion. I just have a few words to share with you, and then we're going to move on throughout the rest of the day and the rest of this weekend. There's a word from the Lord that I want to lift out of 2 Corinthians chapter 4. 2 Corinthians chapter 4 will be our theme passage for today. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, beginning with verse number 6 and following. Well, verse number 5. I'll start at verse number 5 and following. I believe read out of the Message translation out of 2 Corinthians. Listen for the word of God. Remember, our message is not about ourselves. We're proclaiming Jesus Christ, the Master. All we are is messengers, errand runners for Jesus. It started when God said, light up the darkness. And our lives filled with light as we saw and understood God in the face of Christ. All bright and beautiful. If you only look at us, you might well miss the brightness. We carry this precious message around in the unadorned clay pots. In our ordinary lives,
yes, sir.
That's to prevent anyone from confusing God's incomparable power with us. Amen. That's enough. All right. Maybe see. Look what he said in verses 7 and following. He said, if you only look at us,
yes, sir.
You might miss the brightness.
Right.
We carry this precious message around in an unadorned clay pot.
Yes, sir.
Our ordinary lives. I want to use it as a subject as we move our brother to the next level. I want to talk about earthen vessels. Some of your translations have said that you are earthen vessels. We are earthen vessels, and that's all we are.
Yes, sir.
We are clay.
All right.
God scooped us up, made us, shaped us, formed us. We're clay.
Clay.
Yes. And even as we go forward in ministry, we have to be reminded that we are nothing but clay pots.
All right.
God is.